Now let's talk about this concept of array lists. Array lists are special data types. When we want to store information, the same factors that apply to arrays still apply to array lists. It's when we have the same type and we want a lot of the same thing. If it's all student names, then let's just build an array to represent the student names rather than building individual variables to represent the student names, right? So it's the same kind of concept, but we talked about how arrays have limitations on what they can do, and so the array lists address the big limitation of arrays, which is they're not dynamic. Once we say we have an array of 10, then we have an array of 10, right? And shifting around information in that array or deleting information in that array becomes a very difficult process. And so we use this concept of an array list. And the array lists work like this. So a public class, ArrayListFun, public static void main string args. So we build an array list by saying, I want an array list of a certain type. And so we need to define what type it is. Now in this case, I'll just do strings. So I want an array list with strings, and we do that inside these little alligator mouth things. What do they call these? The little, there's like angle braces, I think is what they're called technically. I may be wrong on that. But this is a type of variable. This is a class that is built to handle array lists for strings. And then we give it a name. And then what I was thinking is maybe we do a list of bands. So that's the name of the array, and that's going to be equal to a new array list. String type. And we don't give a number because it's not predefined with ArrayList. We don't say how many elements are going to be in there. That happens as we add elements. But we do need to add an opening closing parenthesis because the ArrayList is a class. Okay, so now what do we do? Well, if we want to add bands, and I was thinking I'd just add in here my top five bands, let's do. So if I'm adding in my top five bands, then the way that we do this is not like a regular array. Normally we'd say bands, if it was a regular array, we'd say bands element 0 equals, and then add the band in. With array lists, the way we do it is we add elements. So we say, go into that bands array and add an element. And the element that I want to add is, and I think it's hard to argue that there's any greater band than the Beatles. I mean, it would be hard to argue that, right? So the Beatles, okay? That's what we add. Who's next? Well, personal preference. I'm a classic rock kind of guy. I do enjoy other types of music, but it seems like I revert back a lot to these classic rock bands. Well, it'd be hard to argue that Zepp is up there too, the mighty Zepp, right? Zeppelin, is that how we spell that? Okay, so there's a band. Who else we got in there? Well, you gotta love the Eagles. That's a great band, right? Let's throw in there a Creedence, right? What a strange name when you think about it. Okay, and then bands, let's throw in, we missed Queen. We gotta get Queen in there. Okay. For some classic rock bands. What's just happened just now in this brief minute that I've been doing this example is I've become very lame to some of you and very cool to others of you, mostly just lame based on my band choices. So that's okay. Um, Okay, minor problem. Cannot find symbol array list. The class array list. Do we need to import? We do. All right, well, I don't know if I. Whoops. We want to import the java.util, the dot array list library. And I'm wondering, maybe I'm just being forgetful here, but I didn't think we used to need to do that. Maybe that's a new version of Java. But anyway, whether it is or isn't, I might have just before just imported all when I did, you know, the scanner and whatnot. So maybe I just never noticed it. But yes, array list needs to be imported separately. Well, once I do this, then this is going to be a highly impressive program that does nothing because I didn't do anything with it. But one of the cool things we can do with an array list is we can actually print it out. We can't do this with an array. It won't print anything. And if I could type it all, this would be really good. So I'm going to print that list of bands, and notice there's my array. The Beatles, Led Zeppelin, the Eagles, Creedence Clearwater Revival, and then Queen. It's added those elements to the array in the order that I added them. And so if I wanted to go through and print out the bands in kind of an up-down list, the way we do that, kind of like we did with the arrays, is to say, let's start with an int I, set it equal to 0. It's still going to be element 0. While I is less than, and I think it, instead of using length, I think it uses size. I could be wrong on that. We'll try it and see if it works. Whenever you hear my voice kind of go like this, it's because I'm turning my head to look at this book I've got next to me to remind myself about stuff. So I plus plus. Let's see if that even compiles. Okay, so I think it is size. And then I can say system.out.println. And then before we would have said with an array, bands element 0. Or actually, we would have done bands element I. Well, we don't have that functionality. We have to use the get method. And so we're going to get element I instead. So it's going to be the name of the array dot get, and then the element that we're looking at. And so in this case, we want it to be I because we want it to change each time we come through this loop from the beginning to the end of the array. And so now if I do this, there I get the bands printed out in order. Element 0, element 1, element 2, element 3, element 4. Okay, so it works a lot the same. So we can add and we can get. And the other thing we can do is, let's say I decide, well, you know what? I really, really like a band that I've missed. Who could it be? I've been on a big Allman Brothers band kick lately. They got some dang good songs. So let's put the Allman Brothers band in, and I'm going to put them in. This is not at all true to my real feelings here, because Queen has got a lot of good songs. They should be up higher. But let's say I wanted to replace Queen with the Allman Brothers band. Well, I can say, now what element is that, by the way? We got 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So one thing that I can do is, after I've done that, I can say go into the bands array and set element 4 to be the Allman Brothers band. I just became even more lame to everybody. And when we do this, then that replaces that element. Go out to element 4 and set it equal to this new value. Notice Queen isn't there anymore. Queen's gone. The Allman Brothers band has replaced it, and so we have a set method as well. All right, so we can get and we can set elements of the array. We can add elements to the array. And here's the part that I think is pretty cool. So let me go back to where I'm not printing this out. Let me go back to where I'm printing it out on one line. So I'll go back to the original way I had it, and then just print system.out.println and print the bands array. So there's the array. Now the cool part in my mind is this, and not just in my mind, and this is one of the reasons they created these, is that I can say, guess what? I decided that I really, you know, don't like the Eagles all of a sudden. So I can say, go into that bands array that I just created and delete element, what would it be, 0, 1, 2. So go in and delete element 2 out of that array. Oh, let me print it off after I've deleted it, so that we can see the difference. And then it's telling me it cannot find the symbol delete with an integer. And I have to remind myself what the syntax is. Oh, remove, not delete, sorry. Remove. And then we pass it the index that we want to remove. Now, this will maybe not be that impressive to you, but this is a really actually an impressive thing. I said remove the Eagles, and what happened to the elements in the array? They all shift down, right? And so one assignment that a lot of teachers like to give is to for you to create a program where you can delete something out of a regular array and have everything shift down one. And it's a major pain to do it because you have to go figure out what element you've deleted and then go back and then fill up those gaps. Everything needs to move back one, right? This just does it automatically. You say remove it and it removes it. And so that's a very cool thing. Another part is, after we remove that element and everything just automatically shifts down, what if I suddenly discover Justin Bieber? Now, I've just made a lot of friends with you. If I say, now go into that bands array and add at position 0, meaning the first position, Justin Bieber. How do you spell his name? Bieber? Bieber. Is it B? I before E? I don't know how to spell it. It's got to be B-E-I. B-E-I-B-E-R. Okay, so Justin Bieber is my new favorite band because I'm trying to win favor with you. He's not a band, but that's okay. Oh, we got to print out our little array after we do that, so we can see the difference. System.out.println. The bands array. And notice what happens. I inserted Justin Bieber into spot 0. And when I did that, everything shifted up. And I really don't think you can appreciate this until you have gone in and tried to write a program that does this just using regular arrays. It's very complicated to go in and say, okay, now add this to the first spot. But before we can do that, we need to open up that spot by shifting everything else down into a new array. This is a much easier way to do that. And so array lists are very cool in that we can add elements, we can delete elements, we can go into the middle and add elements, and everything shifts and works nicely. And so they're trying to fix the limitations of arrays. So the question is, which one is better, arrays or array lists? And the answer, like everything in life, is it depends on what you're trying to do with them. Sometimes arrays are easier, sometimes array lists are easier, and it just depends on what you're trying to do. But if the data is going to be at all dynamic, meaning it's going to change the number that are in there, then array lists are heads and shoulders above arrays. And so that's when we use them a lot of times. They are very useful. All right. Very good. Spencer out.